The Southern Highlands is a biodiversity hotspot, and that diversity locally stems from the different habitats or homes that our local native plants and animals have. That includes eucalyptus forests, swamps, rainforests, cliffs and gorges.
Some of the threatened species of the Southern Highlands are the koala, greater glider, eastern bristlebird, glossy black cockatoo, and the iconically Australian Paddy's River Box. There's more than 50 vegetation communities across the Whinjacarabee Shire, some of which have been listed as endangered ecological communities.
We're also really fortunate to have a lot of natural assets that the community and tourists alike can visit.
The natural beauty and biodiversity around us makes the Southern Highlands an amazing place to live or to visit.
They get to experience nature, they get to visit unique areas of sea species. And that's important for the local economy because it means people coming to the area, possibly staying over weekend, which is important for local accommodation, and then going to restaurants and cafes, which is important for local jobs and local industry as well.
Our business is based on, you know, nature-based experiences and letting people see that, touch it, feel it, understand it, albeit with a touch of luxury. So if we didn't have that, we wouldn't have a business.
We get 30% to 40% from Sydney, and our growing market is the ACT. It's always the ecology of this beautiful area that's forefront, and that's what they want to do. We've got beautiful food producers, we've got beautiful restaurants, but the top of what they want to do is just to get back to nature.
We're a winery that produces our wines off like real sustainable sort of regenerative vineyards. Every issue we come across, it basically comes down to biodiversity. It'd be biodiversity of microbes, which are then related to the biodiversity of the plants, which are related to the biodiversity of the animals. What most regenerative farmers are trying to do is increase their biodiversity on the land. And the results are, you just can't even believe it. We see about a 9% increase into our carbon in our soils, but every 1% gives me about 170,000 litres of extra holding capacity in that water. So when we go into drought, we've got all that extra water there. When we have rain and floods like we have now, it acts like a sponge and sucks it all up. I think a lot of people come and don't realise that they're coming for those biodiversity assets. When you go to a swimming hole and that swimming hole is crystal clear rather than brown, going for a little walk and seeing a platypus, I mean, that's direct result of management and biodiversity.
The health of our ecosystem supports successful agriculture, apiculture and tourism, as well as providing ecosystem services like clean water, clean air and climate stability.
We know already that we consume and we produce more than potentially what this planet can provide, but we're strong and we are clever as a society, and we have many angles at our disposal, including technology, including education, including research. And it's about harnessing all of those to work together with both industry, tourism operators and government to ensure that we can really preserve what we have and not lose more than what we're already losing.
All around the world, biodiversity is under threat, and it's really important that we look at what is happening in our local area. You've got a community of like-minded people that you can work with, and together we can really make a difference.
Like a tug of war.
Oh, well done!
What animal are we planting them for?
Glossy black cockatoos.
Have you ever seen one?
Yes.
No, they have like a bigger beak, don't they? Like a rounder stubby.
I'm always excited how the community has embraced it. Not just the schools, but small groups as well. You put the call out and they'll come running. And then they keep constantly asking, when's the next planting? So Glossy's face is all over the Shire. I don't know if you've ever driven around, but there's murals and it's in the schools, and there's paintings and drawings. 40 to 50% of the schools already have their gardens in. Yeah, not just the bush soaker gardens, but the glossy cockatoo gardens as well. So it's been very successful. And thanks to the locals, the community and the teachers. And it's not just a one-person job, it's a team.
That's what we do. We work with each other. We hang with each other, we see what we can do and how we can actually do amazing collaborations with each other, and that's what we're all about.
There's a real opportunity to better understand what the local environment has. You get a broader understanding of the importance of the local biodiversity.
Really consider what can you do to add back into biodiversity to support the network which you build your livelihood from. Healthy ecosystems really are the basis and foundation of thriving communities.